Gentlemen, welcome back to Vietnam.
Tom Sigel is one of the great DPs working today, so we were very fortunate to get him.
See this whole thing.
I began my career in documentary, and a lot of the documentaries I did were during some of the terrible wars in the 80s. Spike's film is not a documentary, but I think in that experience that I had doing documentaries has had a huge impact on the way we've been telling this story. Spike has always been somebody that loves to be very bold, experimental with lenses, film stocks, certain techniques. And I think for us, we were looking at ways to explore the idea of memory.
I see him.
I saw him dying there.
When we tell their memories, we're telling it with them as older men. And what's interesting about that for me is that memory is not like a fixed thing that's somewhere in your mind and it gets replayed every now and then. Memory comes from all different parts of the mind and it's put back together to recreate that memory for the person. And when you do that, to a certain degree, your memory is evolving. It's changing, it's becoming something different. And so I thought this was a fascinating way to sort of express that.
You've never really seen PTSD dealt with in this particular way, where these characters are older when they have their flashbacks.
We wanted to show there's a difference between the past and present day. So we shot the past, Super 16.
One of the avenues that we thought was really appropriate was to shoot it the way that you would have shot it if you were embedded with the Army in Vietnam in the 60s and the 70s. And we're using a reversal film that Kodak just made for us and also shooting it in a 4:3 aspect ratio, which was the sort of shape that televisions had before our contemporary times. The aspect ratio is something that Spike loves playing with, and we're certainly doing that in this film where our characters begin their journey arriving in the urban part of Vietnam. And it's a widescreen 2:4 aspect ratio. They set out on their journey, and as soon as they get to the jungle and they hit the jungle, the film will open up. It'll go to 1:85, meaning the top and the bottom of the film will get larger. And that was really to sort of give a different feel to the jungle and to the journey that they make through the sort of more wild and dangerous parts of Vietnam. Dangerous, at least in terms of their modern journey. I would hope that watching the film, you have a new take on the Black experience in Vietnam, the notion of brotherhood and what it means to sort of come to terms with the mistakes and deviations you've had in your youth and how to either rectify wrongs or be at peace with the things that you can't change.